I'm Delia.
Hi, I'm Enoch.
And we're Malaysia Adventures.
Okay. Hi guys, welcome back. As promised, this is our first how-to video. Enoch is going to show you guys how to mount the jerry can holder to the back of the Xterra. As you can tell, it's already been mounted to our Xterra, so we will be going backwards. How will you be doing that?
Through magic, obviously. So I'm going to take it apart, and you can follow as I put it back together, and I'll break down all the materials that are needed and tools that are needed to complete the project.
Alrighty, you ready? It's your turn, Right. Come on, Ella, let's go back.
So let's begin the process of reassembling this whole setup. And how I got it all done and what I used to complete it and make sure that it was strong enough to hold the 45 pounds of jerry can and fuel all at the same time. So first thing as we did, we took take off the back section so it's nice and open, like you see here. Two screws at the handle here, which are Phillips head. So we'll take both of those out real quick. I got it. It ran away for a second, but I got it. Here we go. So, handle's off. Leave the screws inside the handle. Makes it easier, you don't lose them. Alrighty. So now, flathead screwdriver. And we'll put this in between the cracks of the plastic and the body. And we'll just kind of pop all the little plastic grommets that hold it in place. And then we go ahead and close it back up. At this point, what I did was grab the jerry can holder, which has the four mounting points on it. I took those and I lined, for me personally, I wanted to leave the Xterra emblem or badging on here. So I went right above the badging. I placed it up against it like so. And then I put a permanent marker and I made four black marks on the paint. And at that point, I got the drill and a half inch drill bit, because I use half inch bolts, and I drilled through all of these spots. As you can tell, they're not perfect, but they're doable, and that's why I decided to use the rubber washer around it as well, to make sure that we sealed up any space that might be between the bolt and the sheet metal, which I'll have to hold that on with the stuff, you know. Anyways, so how did I get the bolts into the jerry can holder? First, I had to drill out the holes so that the bolts would fit through, because as you can tell, these holes are quite small. So I had to drill out the half inch. Once I drilled out the half inch, I took the bolt, I put it through, I put the nut on the other side, and I cranked it down as hard as I could until it sunk into the channel. Once it's inside the channel, like so, it holds itself. You don't have to worry about it spinning. At that point, you can take it, put all they're all locked in place now at this point. You put your fender washer on, and you take your rubber grommet. Which one is that? That's this one. So put the rubber washer on. And then those are still up there from previous installation. But you would take those and put it on each one of the fender washers. And then you line up the holes the best you can. And you work it in. All right, so we've got it in now. That was the easy part. So the next part, on the inside, got everything in nice. So now you want to grab the other rubber washer with the fender washer and the lock nut. All right, so you stack all three of those on top of each other and grab the nut. So then we'll put this over first the rubber washer, because it actually has to stretch a little bit over the bolt. Get that all the way up there. Spin it if you got to. Get it up there. Put the fender washer on, lock washer. It's fully mounted as far as the sheet metal goes. If you want, at this point, I think you would be okay to just have that as the mounting point and not have to do the additional mounts that I did. But to just make sure everything was secure, I decided to go ahead and have these bolts go through the plastic as well, to just stiffen up the plastic and make sure there was less movement in the sheet metal as well. So now I will put the four nuts on there. Put them on evenly on it, and then we'll dry fit that on there before we continue on with the rest, to make sure the nuts are lined up in a good position, so the plastic settles or sets correctly and doesn't bulge out or get pulled in too tight. All right. And on the back side, I taped fender washers to the back side of it where the holes are. And then these push right up against those nuts. And then the other nuts and fender washers, I push those on, and that makes that whole area nice and tight so there's no flex. Let's see how this looks. I think I've got the nuts a little too far back, so I'm gonna bring them up a little bit this way, and then we'll get these guys on. Whole fender washer on these two. Where mine was, I had to bend mine just a little bit so that washer would still be able to actually be used as support on that. And then with this one, it was so close, I ended up having to cut it. But I still have the most of it as support for the nut to distribute the weight. I don't need the handle, but she probably would like the handle back.
I'm short and I need something to hold on to close the door. Or actually, yeah, I need to jump. I jump.
You jump to close.
To close the door. Because he made it so tall. Why does the car need to be that tall? Also,
all the big rocks.
We are currently in Texas at Enoch's parents' house. We're recouping for a little bit from being on the road. And this is generally when we're able to stop and stay with family, is when we do mods like this. So he actually did this mod when quarantine first started and we were in New York with my parents. And yeah, so we're showing you how to do it again now.
Solid. You can put quite a bit of weight on there.
Can I stand on it?
Probably, yeah, actually. I wouldn't be concerned about you standing on it. Now, me, on the other hand, probably not. But, yeah, I think you'd be fine.
Look at those hops.
Do I stand in it?
Yes, stand in front of it. Just slow and gentle.
Oh, shit.
Watch out, all right. Look at that. That's craftsmanship.
Oh, shit. Oh,
she almost went down.
Oh, shit.
Oh, the reason, or I should say, that is the reason I put those fender washers on there is. With the fender washers on both sides and then on the metal and the plastic, that allows all that weight that she just put onto this it distributes that weight over all the space of the fender washers, and that's how it's able to carry so much even though this is sheet metal. Yep. And the last
Ta-da.
Thing this gate goes in right over the top, and there you go. You can find one of these holders in our Amazon link
on our website.
The only other thing that's required after you do this mod to support the weight that this adds, you have to upgrade your struts. I went with 175 pound, and I think if 200 pound would be perfect, and you'd be able to, this would lift itself up even when the gas tank is full. Currently right now, it's about, I would say 15 pounds off from its strength that it needs to push up with a full tank of gas.
Upgrade these. And that's it.
I think, yeah, that's it. That's complete installation. Upgrade the struts and you'll be happy with it.
Alrighty then.
Until next time.
Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, comments, all the above.
Pew, pew, pew. Pew, pew, pew. Hold up. Wait a minute. It's a chopper. Hold up, wait a minute. It's a 22. Pew, pew, pew. Pew, pew, pew.